God kväll. Det hörs ordentligt. Välkomna till Fors kyrka. Här har i hundratals år musiken och sången lyft mot taket i ett rum gjort för musik. Jag läste väldigt nyligen om hur musik i tidiga mänskliga samhällen skapade sång och musik, skapade en möjlighet för fler människor att leva ihop. Om man jämför med våra liksom, kusiner bland djuren, de närmsta, så kan de inte leva i större grupper än 30 personer. Men människor kan leva många fler ihop, och att musiken, sången, skrattet är delar av att det fungerar. Och jag inser nu med Nordic Song Festival att det är så fortfarande med musiken, att den för samman folk, inte bara i det lokala samhället och den lilla gruppen, utan över landsgränser till och med. Så varmt välkomna allihopa.
Thank you so much. It's a pleasure to be here in my hometown, Funtorp, in Fors kyrka, in the church where I was baptized and married and everything. It's very special. Det är mycket speciellt att vara i min egen kyrka där jag är både döpt och konfirmerad, och vi har gift oss också. Det här var en sång till kärleken utav min man Matti Borg, och det är som har komponerat den, men det är till text av Dan Andersson, några texter som är ganska okända och som är gjorda väldigt sent i hans liv, faktiskt inte långt före han dör. This poet is a very well known Swedish poet, Dan Andersson. And my husband Matti Borg made the music, so it's about love, to the love. Now I will go on with another Borg, and that's my father-in-law and my big mentor, Kim Borg, who also was here when we got married, of course. Yes, was all the whole church was so filled. And he was fantastic. I can just say that some of you know him, have heard about him, and I will sing two songs by him. First one is The Highest Heaven Knows. It's a folk song and arranged by Kim Borg. And the next next song is the girl, the young girl that binds her flowers in the night, in the midsummer night, and what's happening there. Så det är den första sången, heter Höga himlen vit, och det är arrangerat en folkvisa av Kim Borg, och den nästa sången är en av tre sånger som han har gjort, en samling sånger till Runebergs dikter. The poet is the Finnish very very well known poet Johan Ludvig Runeberg. Och sången heter Flickan knyter i Johannenatten. Beside that, I will say, tell you that there is 140 collections of music in the library, in the Royal Library in Copenhagen, that he had composed. And a lot of songs, very nice songs.
Att leta ut sin framtidsöden.
end this first part of my songs with two songs by Matti Borg. It's from one of his many collections, 15 songs by Gustav Fröding. En samling av Gustav, med texter till Gustav Fröding. Och det är Matti Borg som har gjort två sånger jag sjunger här, utan de här. Den första heter En vårfest nu. Och ni ska tänka på Anders son och hans badkvinnor i den här sången. En längtan som Gustav Fröding har efter kärlek som han aldrig fick uppleva riktigt. The first song is about the spring fiancé, the spring girl, and we have some artists in Sweden that he was a very good friend with, and who I think he was inspired by his bathing women. The next song, the last song, is Three Singing Girls. Tre trallande jämt kommer hennes i en helt annan nivå där.
Det går så tyst som det döda. We're gonna perform, me, Mats and I, a couple of Icelandic songs as well as one Swedish one. The first song you heard was composed for me in 2018 by a good friend of mine, Finnur Karlsson. The poem by Hannes Pettersson describes a horse treading slowly through a meadow, a snow-white meadow, pondering about life, about man and nature. Man who always places himself in the center, although he isn't. And that was followed by a song from the Passion Hymns by Hallgrímur Pétursson, a prayer I used to recite as a child, actually. In English, the first verse is, "Be thou, O Father, my Father dear, and watch over the path I take. Protect me, Lord, from sin and fear, for gentle Jesus' sake." So man and nature, man and God, which leads to man and Mother Nature. An autumn song, autumn poem, Laufall, Löven faller. The autumn leaves write red runes in the mist as they fall down slowly, like silent words seeking rest. Everything, love and loss, is encompassed by the Eternal Mother. And one day, we will be able to unite with her, in her, rest in the tranquil sunset, as described by Ebba Lindqvist in Gustav Nyström's song, Ute I Skären.
Thank you. This first song is by Sigvaldi Kaldalos. He was actually a doctor and did not have composition as a profession, but he's probably one of the most beloved melody composers in Icelandic language. The song is actually a love song, but it can just as well be a love song to a child, because it's that kind of a text. It's very sort of honest and warm, and doesn't really have this kind of flamboyant love affair flair over it. It's very different from the second song that I'm singing, which is a more dramatic song, also written by somebody who had a very dramatic life, Árni Björnsson. He actually learned to be a composer and composed quite a lot of songs and music. However, he got attacked in the center of Reykjavik when he was a kind of youngish or middle-aged man, and never really recovered from the damage of that. However, we have some lovely songs by him, and this is one of them, Horfin Dagur, a day gone, or the day disappeared.
To sing some song by Jean Sibelius, a big, fantastic composer from Finland, you know. Jag vet, ni känner till mycket väl Jean Sibelius. Den första sången heter Den första kyssen. Och så är det Säv, säv, susa. Och var det en dröm? The first song is The first kiss. And water, grass, seagrass, they are blowing and talking to me. And the next song is, Was That a Dream?
Satt aftonstjärnan från Lunden skymning frågte henne tärnan. Sigan det vore henne grans över östern vid. Det tog hon sig så illa vid. Det vore henne grans över Guds ögon och för hennes ångest Oh.
This song is about a bird. It's the golden plover. I don't know the words or the name of it in Swedish, but it's the bird that comes every year in Iceland, and it's the first indication of summer starting or spring coming. It's actually a tradition in Iceland that when this bird appears, we have a picture of it in the paper, and we all go, ah, oh, summer is coming. It's maybe sort of May. It's true, isn't it? True story. And this song is just about when it falls asleep, everything falls asleep with it. Everything becomes calm and nice and beautiful. The second song is actually a conversation to the cloud, till molnet, I would say. Molnet is the cloud, isn't it? It's kind of a conversation where you sort of have a dramatic sort of look at the clouds piling up. And then, of course, when they pile up, eventually, in the end of the song, they will cry their heart out.
Oh, no.
TV host set, now to something completely different, something more lively, but also quite dramatic, because it's actually the Mice, the Star of May. And it is a kind of a rebellious song by Halldór Laxness, who was very much a communist or a social sort of hero, a writer, the most famous ever Icelandic writer. And he occasionally wrote poetry, and this is something that he just sort of scribbled down, probably on a napkin somewhere, and sent it into a paper for the 1st of May as a song for you know, kind of to fire people up in the fighting for the communist for the communist party and communist sort of idealism. And the song actually was supposed to be a tango, but it was probably not sung a lot in the beginning. It wasn't until many years later that Jón Ásgeirsson actually wrote this song to it. And that became really unbelievably popular and is today kind of almost one of the most popular sort of songs for the Icelanders, not only for people fighting for their rights as a socialist, but also just for people, you know, the sort of optimism of May, summer beginning, and we're actually kind of at the end of it, but I thought it would be a nice song because I think you'll know what I mean when I sing it. Sorry. I was thinking about something else. There's another version and I was a little put off. Let's start again.
And I will switch gears to a slightly faster pace than before. First, we will perform a song, like a small musical remark or a momentary glimpse Composed to a poem by my grandfather, who actually, his birthday is today, which is very nice. How do you feel about the coming winter, says the young man. I haven't given it any thought. I'm still full of summer, says the old lady. Sides of being a musician, the wonders of music, and the lack of money that often follows. But as the poet says, hopefully we'll be reimbursed at some point.
Skóginn eins og í fyrra
Thank you.
the last number, the last song. And we haven't been in Norway yet. This is a, like a trip through the whole Scandinavian countries, yes? So we go to Norway, to Grieg, and one of the best songs I know, it's called Jeg elsker deg, I love you, and the poem is by Hans Christian Andersen.
Min tanke stanke
the children who have been making poems. It's in the art museum in Konsthallen in Trollhättan at 5 o'clock, over also street. And there's also soloist and the chamber choir from Trollhättan. And in the evening at 7:30, it's a nature opera with masks. And man, it's cold. Yes, it's fantastic. So, and it will be in another place, also in very close to normal in the tree or place, but you can see it on the internet. And it's 2 more performances, and on Monday evening, don't miss that opportunity to hear 50 fantastic talent singers and pianists that we have in our masterclass. It's the final concert, and it will be nothing you have ever seen. You have never seen anything like this. They are fantastic, and they are directed by Mette Borg, and it's in the Missionärskyrkan, with a fantastic acoustic and a nice piano, very good piano, and